Even with the terrible weather here in the UK, convertibles are a bunch of fun, and they are best bought during the winter when less people want them. So as we head into the winter, I want to talk about 10 in particular that depreciated down to under £30,000 that I think offer great value for money. If you want to see the same video again at under £20,000 instead, do hit the like button, 1,000 likes and rate that video. Subscribe as well if you're new here, and without further ado, let's get into the video. Let's kick this video off with a car that we never officially got here in the UK, the Chevrolet Camaro SS, which comes with a massive 6.2 litre V8, producing 399 brake horsepower, which will get to 60 in 5.4 seconds. This came with the 5th generation Camaro, which is a pony car to compete with the Ford Mustang. The only issue being that 1, the Mustang is better known in the UK, and 2, midway through the Camaro's lifespan, the Mustang came up for sale here in the UK market, hence these are so hard to come by in comparison. This SS model comes with a different engine depending on whether you go for the manual or automatic, with the manual engine being slightly more powerful. You might know this car based as its role as Bumblebee in the Transformers series, and in convertible spec it would be a fun car to drive around hearing that angry V8 burble. These are on your own £27,000 at the bottom end, but as they're so hard to come by, I only found a 2013 example with 30,000 miles on it. That engine is known to be pretty good on reliability, but terrible from an economy perspective. The complete opposite end of the convertible spectrum to the Camaro is this, the Caterham 7, which you can get in 270R spec with a 1.6 litre inline 4 engine, which puts out 125 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 5 seconds. The Caterham 7 is a stunning little car for the money, very simple in its design and makeup, which is why Caterham still offer a self-build option when buying their cars, which is actually a fair bit cheaper than getting Caterham to do it if you have the space and the tools, but also requires a fair bit of effort too, of course. And to be honest, you're probably better off buying secondhand anyway, as you'll get a better spec car for your money. With Caterham, it's all about handling, which is why they're so popular as track cars. I wouldn't say they're great convertibles because they're maybe not as user-friendly as other cars on this list, but they definitely give you the most raw convertible experience with limited reliability issues. These start at around £18,000, making it the cheapest car on the list, with 30k getting you a 2019 example with very low mileage. The Porsche Boxster 981S is a lovely car for the money, having driven its hardtop sibling in the form of the Cayman S. It comes with a 3.4 litre flat 6 engine, making 310 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.9 seconds. The Boxster came along to open the Porsche brand up to a cheaper end of the market, but has definitely carved its own place as a desirable Porsche, with this being the third iteration, which really modernised the whole package. I would say that the 981 is arguably the best value for money right now, given the 718 was built off of its platform, and lost the typical flat 6 engine that we know and love and do find in the 981. The interior is comfortable and modern on these, and they're very balanced to drive, with a nice engine that sounds even better with the roof down. What is not to love? £24,000 will get you into one, and 30k will get you a 2014 model with 70k on it. They're also pretty reliable, with the main issues being related either to the PDK or small build malfunctions. The Aston Martin Vantage has offered great value for money for ages now, but in convertible spec it is slightly more expensive than in coupe, despite sharing that 4.3 litre V8 engine, which makes 380 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.9 seconds. This arrived a year after the coupe and was slightly heavier than the coupe by 80 kilograms in order for the car to maintain rigidity and have that nice convertible roof mechanism. That roof can go up and down at up to 30 miles per hour, which is great news when city driving, as you can easily escape from unexpected rain, but outside of that, the story is pretty similar to the standard Vantage. If anything, I'd say that this car is a little bit better for a proper grand tour given the roof flexibility. These cost around £28,000 at the bottom end, and 30k will get you a 2008 model with 40k on it. Reliability is genuinely not horrendous on these, but repairs and maintenance can be very costly, with the clutch being a known consumable part. Another British beast now, the Jaguar F-Type S, which is a weird one. I really like it in coupe, and I'll be honest, I don't really like it with the soft top roof up, but when the roof is down, it's a different story. It has lines that are reminiscent of the E-Type convertible, especially at the rear. These come with a 3-litre supercharged V6 engine, which makes 374 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.8 seconds. It would make sense that it's E-Type-esque, given that it's the spiritual successor of that car, and in S-Spec it gained a bit of extra power over the standard F-Type. I've always said that the S is one of the best sounding V6s ever, so driving it with the roof off becomes even more enjoyable hearing the engine sing. I still think I'd take the coupe over the convertible, but that sound would be a lot lot of fun. These start at around £20,000 and 30k will get you a 2017 model with 30k on the clock. Reliability is generally okay on the V6 too, though some owners have questioned the build quality and timing chains have been a problem with these.
So I hope you guys are enjoying this video. If you are, then do hit the like button, I'd really appreciate it. As I said, 1,000 likes and make the same video again under £20,000 instead. And I want to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. When is it unacceptable to use a convertible roof? In the UK, I see people using their convertibles in winter with the blowers on. I want to know, what's your thoughts? Is that acceptable or is that unacceptable?
When the Maserati Gran Turismo had the S upgrade appear in 2010, the GranCabrio arrived too, which is effectively a convertible version of that car. That means it gets the larger 4.7 litre V8 engine, which makes 453 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.7 seconds. And as I've said before, that V8 was developed alongside Ferrari, hence you'll also find it in cars like the 458. That V8 sounds amazing. Maserati always know how to make the most out of an engine sound, so like the F-Type, I think you'd have a great time with the roof down. What's cool is that despite it being a convertible, it retains its four-seat layout, though of course those rear seats are a bit squashed for anyone the size of a typical human. But that does mean that this is Maserati's first ever four-seater convertible. It was a popular car in the US, and honestly, I think considering its Pininfarina designs with a beautiful interior and a mesmerizing sound, I can understand why. £25,000 to get you into one of these, and 30k is enough for a 2011 example that's done 40,000 miles. Just watch out for the known electrical suspension and axle issues with these. Next up we have the baby C-Class AMG, the C43 AMG, which is the first of its kind. Where AMGs in the past have always generally gotten faster and more aggressive, the C43 was actually a step down in terms of performance when compared with the top tier C63 AMG, as rather than the V8 it got a 3-litre twin turbocharged V6 engine, making 361 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.6 seconds. This came with the more recent 4th generation C-Class, and originally it was the C450 AMG before gaining the C43 nameplate. It did actually receive a fair bit of stick for not being a proper AMG, in that it doesn't have the same pace or performance of the C63, and is instead more focused on luxury, but it did still come with a harsher, stiffer ride with that lower, sportier suspension. 20k is enough to get you into one of these, and 30k gets you a 2018 example with 25,000 miles on the clock. Outside of the main consumables being consumed so quickly, in general these have been very solid cars on reliability, with main complaints coming with the material quality not being up to standard. Onto a car that I think has really stood the test of time in terms of looks, the TVR Tamora, which comes with a 3.6 litre inline 6 engine, which makes 350 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.5 seconds. I've always thought that the Tamora looks like it could have come out 5 years ago rather than over 20, at least externally, as the interior is typically TVR in that it's a bit over the top and eccentric. I personally am partial to a TVR, though on purchasing you do have to be aware that they come with a lifestyle. Owners talk about poorly put together parts, an engine that, though iconic, is also a real pain to repair and work on, and generally complain about build quality. But if you can look past that, one, you're probably a TVR fan, and two, this car is properly cool, and probably the most different car on this list. £26,000 will get you into one of these, though they are quite rare, and at 30k you'll get a 2003 model with 10,000 miles on it. When I had the chance to drive the BMW M4 convertible, I was obviously very excited, but I didn't know if I'd actually like it or not. It's big, it's heavy, and it hasn't always had the best reviews around handling. I drove it for around 3 weeks, and in that time I definitely started to understand exactly why it's such a desirable car, and the fact that the start at around £21,000 is insane. Even at 30k you'll be looking at a nice 2016 example with around 50k on it. These come with a 3-litre twin turbocharged inline 6 engine, which makes 424 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 4.3 seconds. It's worth mentioning that this is the only car with a hardtop convertible roof on the list, which for me is pretty huge. It means less maintenance required to keep it looking fresh, and for me it also means it looks better, especially with the aggressive and wider looks of the M4. One thing to be aware of though is the DCT auto box's reliability, as some owners have had issues with them over time. Taking the top spot in this video is the Audi TTRS Roadster, which is a properly fast car for the money, with its 2.5 litre turbocharged inline 5 engine that makes 395 brake horsepower, taking it to 60 in 3.9 seconds, eye-wateringly quick considering. This is the third and final generation of the TT, and only the second TTRS, as the first generation never got an RS model. This third generation massively switched up the general design principles of the car, sticking of course to the shape that people knew and loved, but with a far more angular look. What's amazing is just how rapid it is though. Those specs are almost on supercar levels of performance, even though this sits below the R8 in the Audi lineup. Of course, 2023 is the final year of the TT, so this is the last we'll get to see of this lovely car. This is the most expensive car on the list, starting at around our 30k limit, and and for that you'll get a 2016 example with 40k on it. It's got great reliability too, as that engine has been used and developed over not only TT generations but other Audis too.
And so there we have it, 10 depreciated convertible cars that cost less than £30,000. Now a long time ago did the same video going under £2,000, so if you want to watch that video, click up here. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button as well. 1,000 likes to make the same video again now under £20,000. Huge thanks for watching, and to the patrons for their continued support, and I will see you in the next one.